I come today to speak to my Ohana. I've been around speaking about probate for approximately 7 or 8 years. To make things easy about the probate, I'd like to try to explain it to my family in a simple way. My great-grand-uncles, long time ago, told me this. My family all talk riddles. Just like you hear about the Naha Stone, the Moaku, and all these other stories about Shaman Boy. Well, Uncle always told us, long time ago, Tutu's life was in danger. So the high priest of Hawaii put Tutu in a stone. And one day, Tutu will come out of the stone to help the family for sacred purpose only. Excuse me, I'm getting a hard time to see. Basically, what the probate does, it gives our ohana a direction into how to reunite our families as wanted by the kupunas of that time. The time I'm speaking about is in the time of Kamehameha III, or better known as Kawikiauli. If you look at a probate, it gives you directions and things to do, such as, it's written in a Hawaiian kauna, just like the riddles I just told you about, how to talk about rocks and stuff like that. It's written in riddles. But the probate provides you with names and things that we have to do. One of it is to kahea. So today, I asked my family to kahea to help and save Akua. A lot of us are only looking at land, money, government. That's not the foundation of my family. My family's foundation is Akua. Each and every one of us who have Kanaka blood are descendants of Akua. Things that I'm telling you can be all found in dictionaries, chants, songs. We are all one family. We are all separated, however, at this moment, all with different ideas and goals. When he asked me the question, would I like to see a kingdom of Hawaii, that didn't cross my mind yet. Because I believe in the kingdom of Akua. A government, don't mean nothing to me. If each and every one of you who have Kanaka blood realize that you are a descendant of Akua, and your duty is to malama and take care all of that which belongs to Akua. We've been distracted by white man's ways of ownership, values. It's simple in the old way was the land belonged to God. Kawikiauli, at 12 years old when he became the king, said, I, Kawikiauli, offer my kingdom to Akua. And he also said that he gave his ohana an undivided interest to the land. The Hawaiian people, or the Kanaka, are the owners, all owners of the land, if you look in the white man way, right? At this point, nobody, no government, nobody will listen to us because we are all undivided in our goals. We need to have a set pattern of, why are you fighting atop the mountain for? Is it because you are native? Is it because the mountain's sacred? No. You have to stand up for your identity. Who are you? You have to stand up and say, hey, all us Kanaka, we are all part owners of this land. We all have an interest. Don't let the state or the government tell you, oh, we're going to help you do this, help, we're going to negotiate this and that. No, no, no. You are all blood here. My grandma told me when I call my ohana, what I'm supposed to say is my local, my guy. That means to come, step forward, my blood. We all pilikoko, askanaka to each other. We are all descendants of Kamehameha 1, 2, and 3. We kept one interbreeding. Today we all one family, but divided in our thoughts and in our thinking, in our ambitions. I'm saying the foundation was always a Kua. I mean, if people tell me, oh, how are you going to get Tutu out of the rock? I said, hey, all my grandpa said, my family, as a family, had to pray. So then my nephew tell me, how am I supposed to pray? I said, the only thing you're supposed to pray for, boy, the first, you should let God know, or God know, that He is your one and only God. Next thing you ask Him for is for forgiveness. Because without Him forgiving you, you ain't gonna get nothing. And then, together as a family, ask Him to deliver us from evil. That's all. We're living in an evil world. Evil concepts, money, greed. My dog bigger than your dog. You know what I mean? My house bigger than your house. They got us to challenging each other. We are Hana. We want family. We're supposed to be loving each other. Whatever we get, we share. No, sell me, sell that. I'm gonna make $5 out of this. My God. That's a white man concept. My family needs to keep the foundation based on our core. And if anything, it's not all I have to say right now. But what I would like everybody to do when you have time is at least say the Lord's Prayer and think about what I'm saying. Because if you are a child of